Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about radio immunoassay. It is also known as RIA. So RIA is basically used to determine the concentration of antigens present in the blood serum of the patients. And the basic principle involved behind radio immunoassay is that it is based on competitive binding of radio labeled antigen and unlabeled antigen with selected antibody. So this is the basic principle behind radio immunoassay. So this is the principle involved behind radio immunoassay, and the principle is it is based on competitive binding between radio labeled antigen, and radio labeled antigen is also known as hot antigen, and unlabeled antigen, this is also known as cold antigen, means this cold antigen will come from the serum of the patient with selected antibody, means these antigens will react with the selected antibody which is used for radio immunoassay, and ultimately radioactivity is determined, means radioactivity of this hot antigen will be determined, and accordingly we can do qualitative as well as quantitative analysis by using radio immunoassay. And the basic radio labeled substances which are used in RIA is iodine-125, tritium, that is S3, and carbon-14. So iodine-125, tritium, that is S3, and carbon-14, these are the main radioactive materials which are used for radio labeling in radio immunoassay. And after that I am going to explain two methods which is used in RIA, that is qualitative method and quantitative method. So first I will discuss about qualitative method. So in qualitative analysis, first we will take a microtiter plate, and in that microtiter plate antibody will be present, selected antibody will be present, and in first step, first we will add radio labeled antigen, and after that in second stage we will add cold antigen or unlabeled antigen. Now I am going to illustrate qualitative analysis. So for example, this is our microtiter plate. It contains attached antibodies. So blue color represents the antibodies which are attached on the surface of microtiter plate or microtiter well. Now in this microtiter plate we will put our radio labeled antigen. For example, this X125 is our radio labeled antigen, and it is represented by red circle. So here lot of red circles will be there, means radio labeled antigens will be there. So when we will put this radio labeled antigen into the microtiter well, it will react with the antibody. So here you can see 6 radio labeled antigens are attached. This is only for representation. So here total 4, 8, 9 radio labeled antigens are there. So remaining antigens will be present in free form, means they will not attach with the antibodies. And here bond between this antigen, this one X represents to the antigen. This antigen and iodine-125 radio labeled substance are covalently bonded, means bond between this antigen and this radio labeled substance I-125 is covalently bonded, means bond is strong. So now here this antigen and this antibody will bind with each other, and these are radio labeled. Now in second step, we will put the sample, means we will put the blood serum of patient sample. So after this first step, we will wash these antigens present in our microtiter plate by using buffer solution. And mainly two buffer solutions are used, which are 1% trifluoroacetic acid, and the second one is buffer B. This is buffer A, and buffer B is 60% acetonitrile plus 1% TFA. This TFA is trifluoroacetic acid plus 39% distilled water. So here, after addition of radio labeled antigen, we will wash the microtiter plate by using these buffer solutions to remove all these antigens present in the unbonded form. So in next step, only bonded antigens will be there, and these bonded antigens are radio labeled. Now in this microtiter plate, we will add the serum of the patient's blood, and that serum contains antigen, and that antigen is cold antigen. So this is cold antigen, and this antigen are unlabeled antigen, means they are not radio labeled. Now after addition of this cold antigen, it will go to the microtiter plate, and it will compete with radio labeled antigen, and it will attach with the antibody present in the microtiter plate, and it will replace the radio labeled antigen. So in next step, cold antigen will be attached with the antibody, and hot antigen will replaced by these cold antigens. So here you can see that all hot antigens are replaced by these cold antigens. Cold antigens are represented in green color, and these hot antigens will be washed by using this buffer solution, and ultimately washed solution will be collected in a test tube, and after that we will do centrifugation, and supernatant liquid will be analyzed for radioactivity. So when liquid or washing obtained from this microtiter plate will be centrifuged, then all solid material will sediment at the bottom, and antigen or hot antigen will be present in the supernatant liquid. So this supernatant liquid will be absorbed under radioactive contrast, and ultimately we will came to know about the presence or absence of that particular antigen. So this is the basic principle or basic methodology involved for quantitative method. So here, why we are using this washing solution or this buffer? Because here we are using blood sample as a solution, and as you know, in blood sample many proteins are there. So if we are using this 1% trifluoroacetic or 60% acetonitrile plus 1% TFA plus 39% distilled water, so this buffer solution is also used to precipitate the proteins present in our blood serum. So here, after collecting, here some amount of blood serum will be there. So in that blood serum, proteins will be there, and those proteins will be precipitated first by using this solution, and they will easily sediment. That is why we are using these buffer solutions. This one is buffer solution A, and this one is buffer solution B. They are commonly used. Apart from this, other buffer solution may be used. Now coming to the next method, that is quantitative method. So in quantitative method also we will follow same methodology, but in quantitative method in the place of this cold antigen, first we will use the standard solution of cold antigen, means concentration of cold antigen will be known to the analyst, and after that at the end we will add the sample solution. So here you can see that radio labeled antigens are attached with antibody in step 1. Then this is step 2. So what happens in step 2? In step 2 we will add the standard unlabeled antigen, and the concentration of that standard unlabeled antigen is known to the analyst. So for example, first we are adding 1 nanogram per ml solution, then after that 2 nanogram per ml solution, then after that 3 ml per ml solution, then after that 4 ml per ml solution, then after that 5 ml per ml solution. So at the starting, in this step, if we have not added any amount of standard cold antigens, so in first step if we will wash this micro titer plate by using buffer solution, and after that we will collect that washing, then radioactivity of this washing will be 0%. So in first step no hot antigen will be present, means no amount of radio labeled antigen will be present in the washing. Now in next step, if we are adding 1 nanogram per ml solution of cold antigen, then for example this hot antigen will be replaced by 1 cold antigen, and this hot antigen will be released, and this will go to the next step. So in next step, for example, it is showing 10% radioactivity because of 1 nanogram per ml cold antigen. So this 1 nanogram per ml cold antigen will replace the some amount of hot antigen, and that amount is showing 10% radioactivity. Now in next step, again we are adding 2 nanogram per ml solution of cold antigen, then again it will replace 1 hot antigen, and it will be so here we have added 2 nanogram per ml of cold antigen, and that cold antigen will attach with our antibody, and that hot antigen will be replaced by this cold antigen, and this hot antigen will again go with the buffer solution or with the washing, and that washing will be collected like this, and this collection will be centrifuged, and after centrifugation this collection will be analyzed in radioactive counters. So ultimately gradually radioactivity of the solutions, of the collected solutions, will be increased, and we will get the standard curve for radioactivity. So here I am going to draw the standard curve for radioactivity. Before that just I will write the next concentration. This is just an example for representation. Actually it may, percentage may vary. So in y-axis radioactivity is there. So here this is 0%, 10%, 20%, 30%, 40% and 50%. So in x-axis concentration of cold antigen is increasing. So here standard curve will be like this. So after preparation of this standard curve, again we will take this antigen antibody complex in a micro titer plate, and after that we will put our sample for analysis. So this is the micro titer plate containing radio labeled antigen, and this is cold antigen coming from the serum of the patient, and this cold antigen will replace these hot antigens according to the quantity present in the serum of the patient. And these are the replaced antigen or hot antigen, and this hot antigen will be analyzed by radioactive counters. And ultimately these hot antigens will show some radioactivity. For example, these hot antigens are showing activity 8 here. So how we will determine the concentration of this hot antigen? Now we will extrapolate this graph. So it is between 3 to 4. For example, if it is 3.2, so concentration of antigen present in the serum of the patient is 3.2 nanogram per ml. So this is the mechanism of quantitative analysis. Now coming to the stepwise methodology for radioimmunoassay. So in first step we will take micro titer plate containing antibody. And after that add cold antigen. If we are doing quantitative analysis, then we will add standard cold antigen solution. After that, washing of micro titer plate is carried out, and washed solution will be collected, and collected solution will be proceed for the centrifugation, and after centrifugation supernatant liquid will be analyzed by using radioactive counters. So here liquid collected is proceed for centrifugation, and it is done at 1200 to 4000 revolution per minute, and after centrifugation supernatant liquid is analyzed under radioactive counters. Mainly two counters are used for detection of radioactivity. First one is gamma counter. If we are using iodine 125, then we will use gamma counter. If we are using tritium means H3 and carbon 14, then we will use scintillation counter. In my upcoming videos I will definitely discuss about these counters in details. So this radioimmunoassay is used to determine hormones, it is used to determine antigens, it is used to determine many drugs, it is used to determine allergens. If this radioimmunoassay is used to determine allergens, then it is known as RAST, that is radioallergosorbent assay. So this is the basic idea behind radioimmunoassay. Thank you.